Estee Skyle to play here in Berlin.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. We're just testing the audio first, making sure the audio works. Testing, testing, making sure the audio works. I like to do this every time I do a Twitch stream, just to make sure I'm properly calibrated my system. We're just testing the audio, making sure the audio works. Stream, just to make sure. Okay, now we're ready. Hello again. Welcome back to Video Gamers Oasis on Twitch. I'm your lovable, huggable host, Jeremy, back again. And I thought I would, I want to do get back into gaming again this year. But for now, we're taking it slow. We're going to be learning some guitar. Now, this is the software I've been doing earlier this year, actually, and end of last year as well. Teach yourself to play guitar CD-ROM. There's a link in the description of this video. I encourage you to get this software yourself. But in case you can't afford it, I'm going to be doing some lessons. Actually, have been doing some lessons for a long time. Went through the entire CD-ROM last few months. But I've decided to redo it because I actually want to do some practicing. I don't want to just be a guy who plays videos on Twitch of how to play guitar. I want to actually practice guitar. So what I've done is taken photographs of the dude and his notes in the CD-ROM. You can see here. I'm going to have to set up a nice camera setting where I can have close-ups. Right now, everything's a bit chaotic right now in my office. I only have a limited amount of space in my office, so I'm not able to have like a cool video station. But that's one of the plans I have for this show, the series that I'm doing. I'm going to have a video filming station with different shots, not just of my handsome, lovable face, but also of books and games and toys, anything that I like to show off. I want to have a close-up screen. That's not going to happen right now, but it will be in the future. So thanks for your patience. So we're going to start right from the beginning of the CD-ROM. But unfortunately, I made some video recordings. So hopefully I should be able to get right to the video and that I've recorded. So let's go to what I've recorded so far, because that's why I made those digital recordings, in the past, was I was doing that so I can be able to, I could study for later. So look at the guitar, teach yourself to play guitar CD-ROM, go to videos, and we're going to get started. We're just going to start a video from the beginning. Let's go introduction. Hopefully this works the way I want it to. This works. I'm going to continue doing this every day as much as I can. All right, just the introduction. Here we go. Okay, this is I'm updating my VLC. My VLC just crashed. Okay, now we're ready. We're getting started all over again from the beginning. Because we're gonna practice this time. We're not just watching videos. And we're doing this once a week. Make it a habit.
Hi, and welcome. My name's Jeff. And I'm going to be your guide through this Teach Yourself to Play Guitar CD-ROM.
Okay.
Now before we get started, there's a couple things I'm going to cover. First of all, when you want to advance to the next section of the program, just click the arrow in the upper left-hand corner of your screen. Now before we actually get started playing, I'm going to teach you a couple things about different kinds of guitars, about guitar maintenance, and about how to tune your guitar.
Okay.
Well, let's get going. Click on that arrow and we'll move on to the next part of the program.
All right. So since, folks, this is going to be a straight from the beginning, actual lessons, we're going to go in depth. We're not going to do this fast, so I'm going to do this as slow as possible, and I'm not condescending to anybody. This is for myself. I know how to play guitar basic chords, but I'm going to teach myself musical notes as well, And I want to really take it slow for myself because I'm a slow learner, but once I learn, I won't forget. So we're gonna take this really slow, and I don't know how long these lessons are gonna take, but I'm gonna do this at least once a week. So let's get started, acoustic guitar. All right. Just crashed, I don't know why it's crashed, okay. Let's see if I can get this thing working. All right, I want to move the arrow. Acoustic guitars. He's going to teach me acoustic guitars, I think. This is a video I did earlier.
All right, let's talk about the different types of guitars, starting with acoustic guitars.
All right.
There are two basic types of acoustic guitars. Okay. We have the acoustic flat top guitar, which has a flat top, a narrow neck, and steel strings. And they're played either with a flat pick or with finger picks. And they're used in rock, blues, and folk guitar. And they sound something like this.
Okay, so far so good.
The classical guitar is our second type of acoustic guitar, and it also has a flat top, but it has a bit of a wider neck, and it has nylon.
He's got his legs crossed. We're gonna do that later. He's gonna instruct us how to position your guitar. Spanish guitar. So that was just the lesson. We're just learning about the different types of guitars. Let's learn about electric guitars. Lesson, acoustic guitars. Let's move on to the next one. I think it's electric guitars. Here we go. Try it again. Lesson, acoustic guitars. Let's move on to the next one. I think it's electric guitars. Here we go. Crashed. Okay, you know what? We'll just watch the CD-ROM because this video is obviously not working well for me. But you know what? That's not going to be a problem. I'm just going to pop in my CD-ROM, and we're going to put in my program and my game section. And we're going to start it up again. Play it on the program under getting started. Because I've already taken some snapshots of the notes as well. We're on lesson number one. Section 2. Let's get this correctly started. Acoustic guitars, electric guitars. Reviewing this again. We've already done this before, but I want to get through the entire lessons without wasting time, without goofing around. CD-ROM's taking a little bit longer than usual. CD-ROM, what's wrong with you?
All right, let's talk about electric guitars. There are two basic types of electric guitars. The first is the solid body. It's got a solid body, a narrow neck, and light gauge steel strings. It's also got...
I had some friends I used to socialize. I used to socialize with a rock band, an actual garage band, and I did play around with a guitar, electric guitar. It was a lot of fun.
In this case, three electric pickups. Now, the signal from an electric guitar gets fed through an amplifier and sometimes other effects like a wah pedal, distortion, or chorus. This kind of guitar is generally used in rock, country, blues, and jazz.
Okay.
And it sounds a little something like this. Guitar we're going to talk about is a semi-hollow. It has a semi-hollow body and it has these F-holes in it, which give it a warmer, richer tone than a solid body guitar. It's also got a narrow neck and light gauge steel strings. This kind of guitar is generally used in jazz and blues, and it sounds a little something like this.
A little bit of B.B. King style there. All right, let's go to the next one, which is caring for your guitar. And this is a small print, so I'm going to read it out to you folks because I have it snapshotted and saved for just such an occasion. So let's make sure we... make sure to follow me, follow Video Gamers Oasis on Twitch if you haven't already. We'd appreciate it. And Video Gamers Oasis on YouTube and Video Gamers Oasis VOD channel if you want to see all my Twitch videos on YouTube, all my Twitch videos captured on YouTube, except my Minecraft videos, which is VideoCraft Toots. Subscribe to that one as well. So let's go to guitar, and we'll save that under guitar. Teach yourself to play guitar, images, getting started. We'll get a zoom in on this just a moment because it's very small print, and I want to make sure we get all the important information and don't miss anything. And we're just gonna making sure I'm broadcasting properly, making sure everything's broadcasting, everything's good. Okay, let's read this little handout sheet. And I encourage you, if you want to, you can take a snapshot of this image and keep it, make yourself, if you so desire, you don't have to. But if you feel inclined, make yourself a old Duotang or binder and photocopy these pages that I'm showing you into a and put them into a binder and study them on your own time. Here's an illustration here of The Who. The Who took a larger-than-life approach to rock performance, perhaps inspired by guitarist Pete Townshend's compositions, which were as theatrical as they were powerful. Including among these was Rock's first opera, Tommy, released in 1969. And I know that for a fact that The Who was famous or infamous for smashing their musical instruments after each performance. I don't think they do that anymore, but they definitely had an awesome performance and musical rock opera, Tommy, the boy who could not see, hear, or speak. But the deaf, dumb, blind kid sure played a mean pinball. What's else information here? Rule number one. Rule number one, folks. So you may want to write some notes down if you want to start guitaring for the first time. Rule number one is to never expose the instrument to the extremes of heat or cold. Rule number two is to make sure the strings are tuned to an accurate pitch. Tuning the strings too high can have serious consequences for the instrument, causing the neck to bow or the bridge to rip out of the top. So let's keep that in mind. Make sure the strings are tuned to an accurate pitch. I tune my strings almost every time I play. I kind of have an ear for music, but the software also has a tuner, so you can tune with the software. Rule number three is to wipe the strings off after playing and polish the instrument using guitar polish. Now, I have to confess, I have not done that before, but I'm thinking next time I go to a guitar shop, I'm going to look for some guitar polish and get a soft, clean cloth to polish my guitar and strings. And finally, rule four is to have a repairman check over the instrument twice a year, just before the summer and winter. And that's something I have not done for a long time. But I have, years ago, when my dad was still alive, we took my guitar to a guitar shop, and we had one of the strings were actually busted, and we had the guitarist shop owner, he actually replaced all the strings for me. Of course, it cost me a pretty penny, but it was worth it. He put some really high quality strings onto my guitar and he tuned it up beautifully. So I highly recommend, if you are really serious about learning to play guitar, I would suggest you go to a guitar shop once you have your guitar and have a guitar technician inspect your guitar. And if you need to replace the strings by all means. You'll be happy you did, because you want to play a really high quality pitched musical instrument. And so that is getting started with the rules. Let's move on to the next section, getting started tuning your guitar. Now here is another handout. So I'm going to show you what I took a picture of. So I encourage you to take a snapshot of my picture that I'm going to show you, and I put a picture of it in your binder for later. Tuning your guitar. All right, so we're going to take a look very close up. This is from the actual software, but I took a snapshot of the image because it's such a small little image. Click on the tuning pegs and tune your guitar to match the pitch. We have the fourth string D, fourth string D, fifth string A, sixth string E, third string G, second string B, and first string E. But of course, E is the first string that we want to play. Select guitar tuner from the start menu to tune your guitar using the tuner. And we have the frets. We have fret number E is A, fret number 4, then fret number 5, and fret number G. A is on 6, on the E 6, I think. D, A 5 is D. Okay, you have G, B, and E. We're going to go through all those chords in detail. I'm sorry if I'm not a very good teacher right now, not with it today. I'll do the best I can with the help of the teacher, Jeff. But I'm going to show you what I'm learning as we go along, because we're going to be needing to know how to read music. So let's go back to what we were doing. Let's take a look at tune. Click on the following pegs and match your pitch. Select guitar tuner from the start menu. Okay, we have to click start menu. Click on the start menu. Click guitar tuner. Guitar tuner. We're going to load it up. Tune your guitar. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to see if this works here the way I want it to. Sharp DB. Could be a little off tune there. Okay, I'm gonna have to practice some more, obviously, but this is basically a tuner, guitar tuner software. Let's move on. Holding your guitar. This is important.
There are several correct ways to hold the guitar. Sitting like this.
Okay. Like this.
With your legs crossed.
Legs crossed. Like this. Ugh.
Or standing.
Or standing. Or standing. Like this.
Try each position.
Now I have a strap here on my leather, a leather strap on my shoulder. If you don't have a leather strap and you want to stand up, I'd suggest you go to your local guitar music store. Get yourself a strap there. Or if you can find one at a discount store, get one there. So you can stand up if you want to, if you so desire, and do your performances on a stage. All right, let's move on. Getting started hand positions.
Now let's talk about left hand technique.
Okay.
Notice that the thumb falls nearly opposite the knuckles on the second and third fingers.
Well, hang on here. I'm going to, I want to play that first.
Elbow in, keep your fingers curved. And when you place a left-hand finger on the guitar, you want to press firmly and as close to the fret as possible without actually being on it. This will ensure a clean, bright tone.
I'm going to set up the... I'm just going to set up my Streamlabs software. We're going to set it for close-up. So now I have the close-up of the image of me playing the guitar, so you can have a better look at this while I'm playing the video in the corner. Because we're actually gonna learn something here. We're not actually just goofing around. We're actually watching and learning.
Now let's talk about left-hand tip. Notice that the thumb falls nearly opposite the knuckles on the second and third fingers.
Okay.
Now keep your elbow in, keep your fingers curved, and when you place the left-hand finger on the guitar, you want to press firmly and as close to the fret as possible without actually being on it. This will ensure a clean, bright tone. Proper right-hand technique using a pick involves holding the pick firmly between the thumb and forefinger, but not so firmly that you create tension in the arm. You want it to be loose. And then you're going to strum down with the wrist in a sweeping motion like this. The whole arm to the wrist. And you want to practice because that might take some getting used to. If you don't want to use a pick, you can just use the heel of your thumb like this. To better understand guitar notation and diagrams, please note that all the fingers...
All right, we're going to go back to the note, actually, up to the other screen. But first, let's have a quick look at how I'm doing this. Pick. Let's have a little close-up of my video. All right, we're going to... Just going to practice our strumming. Look on the camera, of me playing the guitar. See, this guitar needs some tuning. And let's go back to the original broadcast style. We're going to go back to what we're going to have a little bit of theory. So write some notes down.
Fingers on the left hand correspond to numbers.
Numbers.
The index finger is number one.
Number
the
one.
The middle finger is number two.
Number two.
The ring finger is number three. And the pinky is number four.
Number four. Okay. Let's do that. Let's review that, shall we? All right, folks. Let's remember the fingers. All right? No, I'm not gonna go there. All right. Peter pointer is number one. The middle finger is number two. The ring finger is number three. And the pinky finger is number four. Remember those fingers. Those are very important if you want to learn how to play guitar. All right. Getting started, notes and
you
the staff.
You may already know that musical sounds are indicated by symbols called notes. Their time value is determined by their color, black or white, and by the stems and flags attached to the note. The name and pitch of the note are determined by the note's placement on a staff. The staff is a graph comprised of five horizontal lines and
okay.
The spaces in
this
between.
This is important.
The notes are named after the first seven letters of the alphabet, A through G, and are repeated to embrace the entire range of musical sounds.
All right, fortunately, this is for me. I took a snapshot of the image that we're discussing so we can have a better, closer look at what we're looking at. Let's go to the actual image of the staff here. That's not what we're looking for. It's another image. Okay, We already talked about number one, number two, number three, and number four. For the four fingers. Now we're going to go over to not yet. We're not doing tabs just yet. Okay, so here's a close-up of what we're doing. We have we're going to study in depth the different types of notes. Well, here we have the bar, the line. The first line is E, first space. Second line, F and G. Okay, first line is still E and F, is still on the first space. The second line is on G, second space. Third space is the third line, B, A and B. Then we have the fourth line, C and D, third space. And then we have the fifth line on the fourth space, E and F. So we're gonna study that in more depth later on. Getting started, measures
and
clefs.
Music is also divided into equal parts or units called measures.
Measures.
One measure is divided from another by a bar line. During the evolution of music notation, the staff had anywhere from 2 to 20 lines, and symbols were invented to locate a reference line or pitch by which all other pitches were determined. These symbols are called clefs. Music for the guitar is written in the G or treble clef.
Okay. So let's take a look at those clefs. I'll use my Photoshop, and we're going to go over to what we want to look at. Here we have a close-up of bar lines. Measure, arrow left, arrow right, and measure, arrow left, arrow right. In the middle is the bar lines, and of course, clefs are the notes that we use to measure on these bars. Pretty straightforward. If I'm talking very condescending, it's not intentional, but for myself, I'm basically relearning what I've learned in the past. I've known music, I've been taught music before, but I've struggled when I was a kid with severe slow learning and difficulty with sitting still. I wasn't able to focus because of my hyperactivity as a kid. So I'm learning myself basically from the beginning. So you'll have to please be patient with me as I sound like I'm condescending, but I'm not. This is how I learn, is by taking things very, very slow and very, very gradual. So I hope you can not take offense if I'm talking like a preschooler with my slow learning. It helps me learn better when I learn very slowly and repeat things again and again. It helps my brain process the information. Getting started, how to read tablature.
Tablature is a graphic method of showing how to play notes and chords on the guitar. It uses a six-line staff, with each line representing a string on the guitar. A number placed on a line means to play that fret on the corresponding string. Numbers placed one on top of the other are played simultaneously.
Okay, let's take a close-up of the tablature. Let's take a close look at that. So we're going to look at tablature. This is just a snapshot of what we just learned. All right, here is the notes here, tab. First string, second string, third string, fourth string, fifth string, and sixth string. A number placed on a line means to play that fret on the corresponding string. So we have the third. We have number three on the first string, meets first string, third fret. Next, we have second string, first fret. Then, next we have third string, open. Open is a zero. Zero means open. And fourth string, second fret. Next, we have a banner introducing the bar, and it says numbers placed one on top of the other are played simultaneously. We have first string open, second string, first fret. Then we have the second third and fourth strings open. All three of these are 0, 0, 0. Next we have first string, first fret, plus three strings open, 1, 0, 0, 0. And then finally we have a five note C chord. Five note C chord is 0, 1, 0, 2, 3. It's almost like binary code, which is not, but it's this very complicated if you don't know what you're doing. But excuse me, pretty straightforward. We're gonna learn this really in depth in the future. I just want to introduce you to it. So we're gonna learn about notes
now
in the first string.
Let's start playing. E is the thinnest string, and it's also closest to the ground. When the E string is sounded open, it sounds the note E and looks like this on the staff.
Let's try that again. Where's my E string? Where's my pick? Got my pick right here. All right, let's do. I want to hear how he did it again.
Now it's time to start playing. We're going to start with the first string, E. E is the thinnest string, and it's also closest to the ground. When the E string is sounded open, it sounds the note E and looks like this on the staff.
Let's do that. Could be a little off. All right.
When the E string is played with the first finger on the first fret, it sounds the note F and looks like this on the staff. When the E string is played with the third finger on the third fret, it sounds the note G looks like this.
All right, let's have a close-up of what I'm doing. We're going to take a close-up of my camera. So we know what we have an idea of what we're doing here. All right. See what I'm doing here? First fret. Pinching it here. All right, let's hear what more Jeff has to say.
When the E string is played with the third finger on the third fret, it sounds the note G and looks like this on the staff.
Third finger on the third fret. So let's 2, 3. So there's three fingers on that one string, it's G.
To get used to playing these new notes, try the next example.
Okay. Let's go. We're actually on notes on the first string E. This is actually the second lesson. We're gonna be moving forward a little bit faster than usual, but not too fast. We're going to finish this song lesson for today. First, let's finish it up. Let's go to my screen, and we're gonna go to Play Guitar Live. All right, let's do this. So do this song here. This will be a little bit of a homework assignment for anyone who's interested in doing this on your own. Let's see if we can record this, each one. All right, so that's the first one. Dun. obviously not perfect, but I basically get it. You get it. I'm going to take a snapshot of this anyway, because I need to practice in more depth. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a snapshot of mixing it up. See if I can capture it with my, I made a video of it already. So I'm just seeing if I can just get my, VLC video maker, video player, pardon me. And we'll go to guitar, under teach yourself to play guitar, video, and we'll put it under notes in the first string, E. Let's see if we can. All right, we're gonna take a snapshot of that before we close up today. Take a snapshot, mixing it up. And we'll save that as mixing it up one. Let's put this under guitar. We'll put this under video, we'll put this under image. And we'll save that as one. And we'll next one. Then we'll save that again. Save that as two. Save that as three. Number three. We'll save that as four. Lesson number four, and not lesson number, note number four. Next chord. Put that in the beginning. This is the only way I'm going to learn, is if I learn really slow and very basic stuff first before I get on to the more advanced stuff. So we already did four, now we're doing five. Number six. Number seven. Say that is number seven. I say that is number eight. Say that is number nine. Okay. Save that as number 10. Save that as number 11. Save that number as number 12. Say that as number 13. Number 14. Number 14. Number 15. Number 15. Say that as number 15. Number 16, maybe. And number 17. Save that. All right. Save that. Why aren't you working? Save that as 17. Save as. Save as 17 and save. I don't know why it's not saving, so you get the idea. You get the gist. And there you have it, folks. That's basically the long and the short of it. That's a good assignment for us to start with, anyone who's learning guitar for the first time. I'm going to practice that off camera, and then maybe I can perform it another day. So there you have it, folks. Very basic stuff. Extremely, extremely basic stuff. Thanks for watching. We're going to take a little break here. I'm going to practice those notes specifically and practice like crazy, because I'm the only, you know, Bruce Lee once said, a very wise man once said, he said that I fear not the man who can do 1,000 kicks, but I fear the man who can do one kick 1,000 times. So that's what I'm going to be doing, is this one song, which is extremely basic, again and again and again until I perfect it. And I'm going to take a little break right now and do that off camera. And then when I master it next week, I'm going to be performing it for you folks on Twitch. So thanks so much for watching Video Gamers Oasis on Twitch. Send some likes, send some love if you like this very awkward and cringy tutorial. I hope it's helping someone out there who wants to learn guitar. Now I'm going to take a little break. I got some errands to do. I helped my mom out with cooking and stuff. But I will be back again later on tonight. I'm taking it down a notch with some Minecraft. Minecraft is always a great way for me to relax and get my mind off stressful things. And I hope you'll join me then. Video Gamers Oasis on VOD is this channel, the YouTube channel upload. And later on, we're going to be uploading after we do a broadcast of Twitch of Minecraft. We're going to do VideoCraft Toots. So thanks for watching. Follow me on Twitter at VideoCraft Toots. Video Tweets. Video underscore Tweets. So I got a little mixed up there. Video Gamers Oasis on Facebook. And my main channel is Video Gamers Oasis. Thanks so much for tuning in. I also do a chess tutorial podcast. It's kind of awkward and cringy where I'm reading a book. But if you like to learn how to play chess, watch my weekly podcast where I'm just reading from the book and doing some practical applications of what I learned. So a lot of cool stuff on the horizon. Thanks for watching. I will see you again real soon. Bye for now.